man, it's good to see you. I feel like no matter how much time has passed, when I'm with you, time just stands still and there's college all over again.
Yeah, I mean, it must be nice for you to say because you've adulted. I'm basically just a man-child.
Oh, tell me about it. I've just drafted my first will.
Oh, does that mean that I'm going to get
Yes, you are getting the Charizard card. Don't you worry.
Oh, I'm low-key looking forward to your death.
Oh, you're that low on cash, huh?
Come on, man. I don't really live on much. You know this. I mean, my monthly budget is probably lower than your phone bill.
Shit.
By the way, nice tie, suit. How'd the meeting go?
Really well, actually. Thanks very much. You know, it could potentially be a lot of money for my family. It's just the workload is bothering me.
Last time with Frank and the kids. So, is it worth it?
I mean, this is what I've been building towards all these years. Wouldn't it be a huge waste if I said no right now?
Like, how much more do you need? Are you gonna buy a new car?
Come on, college tuition is expensive, all right?
Yeah, I know. I'm still making monthly payments for that useless piece of paper. I mean, God knows it's not gonna help me in the Amazon next week.
Wait, that's where you're off to next? I mean, isn't all of this running around getting a little bit exhausting?
Oh yeah, endless days of storytelling just really gets to me. Please tell me more about your 11-hour work days of back-to-back calls.
Okay, fair enough, but can't you just do something easy? I mean, aren't there like a million things that could kill you in the Amazon?
Yeah, and heart disease isn't one of them. When's the last time you felt truly alive? That's the problem, man. You won the ovarian lottery, okay? You're born in a developed country, just use your privilege and travel more.
Come on, I work in a hyper-competitive field. If I end up taking more than my 2-week vacation a year, I probably risk losing my job altogether. Look, I acknowledge my privilege just as much as you do. I guess I'm just using it in different ways. Right now, I'm amassing wealth and influence so that in the future, I can make substantial change. But there's a big difference between utilizing your privilege and exploiting it. I mean, what the fuck are you doing?
I'm living my life, man. I can't even count the amount of lives I've touched in positive ways. And I didn't do it for some third-party fucking tax write-off. I'm closing the gap between cultures around the globe.
Sure, but I mean, don't you want to work towards something a bit more permanent? Like, A permaculture farm.
I mean, maybe. But first I gotta find a place that I can consider home. Cause this city sure as hell isn't.
You know, home isn't what you find. It's what you build.
Time is the only resource that we have. We're both running out. We're all running out.
Yeah, but you realize it's not just my own time. It includes that of my future generations. Wait, you're never gonna have kids, are you?
Not intentionally, I won't. I have goals, and they're my own. I never felt the need to immortalize myself with offspring.
So, your goals die with your last breath?
Not necessarily. I mean, my goals may be less tangible than yours, but that doesn't mean that they're less important. Hey, you're my best friend. I don't want you to look, you know what the last regrets are on people's deathbeds.
Yeah. Wish I traveled more.
Spend more time with your family. We can't fucking regret things, man, because every single mistake that I've made has made me who I am right now, and I love who I am, so that means by definition they were mistakes.
Likewise, if I didn't love who or where I am, I'd change something about it. Because if you didn't, that's next level regret. But you know what? I have a feeling you keep talking about my lifestyle like it's shit, even though you don't know the slightest thing about it.
What are you talking about? I tried it and I almost killed myself.
Okay.
No, seriously, I almost killed myself. And that's how I know that the decision to leave was the right one. Like, you decided not to travel.
Well, I didn't choose directly not to travel. It was more a consequence of wanting to build a career and raise a family.
Yeah. I guess I didn't really wake up one day and say I only want to see my family once a year. I guess every decision and opportunity has a cost, right?
What the fuck do we know? I mean, in the future, we're probably going to regret all the decisions we feel so confident about.
Yeah, I might regret all of this by the time I'm 50.
50, dude, come on. You're going to die in the Amazon.
Nah, man. The jungle's more hospitable than you think. But the desert, though.
Hey, man, what's up?
Hey, Kev, you won't believe what's going to happen.
What's up? What's going on?
I'm gonna come visit you, finally.
No. Really? When?
Yeah. How about tomorrow?
Tomorrow? That's amazing, for sure. Do you have the flight booked?
No, I'm gonna do that right away.
Okay. Send me the information when it's all booked. I'm going to be at the airport at the time that you arrive, and everything's taken care of when you're here, man.
Sweet, that's fantastic. I'm going to do that right away and we'll let you know. All right?
Perfect. Yeah.
Okay.
See you soon.
Excellent.
Yes! Peace, man.
Ninth hole, par 4, elevated green. If you hit the ball 10 feet over the green, you're in the Atlantic Ocean.
I love Puerto Rico. I went to Puerto Rico. I kind of have a weird story in Puerto Rico. A monkey stole my wallet, and I had to like try to bargain with it, you know, with the banana. I was like, oh, take the banana, give me the wallet.
Once I was in India, there was this guy, he's like holding his phone, right? And this monkey comes down from the bridge, just snatches it out of his hand, takes it back up, and he's making eye contact with him, like holds it over the river and just drops it.
No way.
So clever.
Oh my God, wait. When I was in Panama, we were camping in the jungle, and all we could hear at night were these howler monkeys, and my God, they're so loud, they're like,
Yeah, actually, I've never really left the States, except, well, that one time when I saw my mum's family in Norfolk in England.
Oh, a nice family time of four.
Yeah. Let's go get a beer.
Oh, yeah, love that.
See you later.
See ya. Bye.
Just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away into the magic night. I softly say a silent prayer, like dreamers do. Then I fall.
But it was a little bit awkward in there.
Elizabeth, you think? I mean, come on, all these people talking about freaking monkeys jumping around in the Caribbean. You know that I have never been, you know, really outside my comfort zone.
I know, but it's like, you know, they're kind of more like me. Like, it's all we've got. We're travelers. We hang on to our stories. Like, we hang on to our backpacks. We hold them tight. We hold them dear. And it's like, that's it. We never really built the things that you've built, like, you know, you have the house, you have the car, you have these muscles that you've been working out, you know, because you have the routine. We don't have routine.
Yeah, I guess, I mean, look, I'm super happy that I've come out here. It's super nice meeting your tribe, but I've also realized I miss my husband, my kids, my projects, and, you know, I can't bloody wait to go back home, honestly.
I can't fucking stand the idea of going back.
Well, you know what? Cheers to that, dude.
Cheers, man.
Oh man, thanks again for coming out. It was such a good ride and like a pleasure to have you here.
I mean, of course I had to with those Insta shots, but the culture shock is real.
I probably should have warned you that there's like a whole farm of animals just kind of living outside my place.
Oh, yeah, at bloody 5 a.m. I realized that.
Cock a fucking doodle doo, bud.
Seriously, they don't know what time it is, do they?
No, they're completely lost.
Yeah.
Yeah. Street food on the first day probably wasn't my wisest choice.
Yeah, maybe not. Actually, I'm really looking forward to have a solid poo for a change.
I've never seen anybody run to the toilet as fast as you ran.
Seriously, disgusting.
Day.
Like, I feel like it was shooting out left, right, and center.
Oh my God, you could have painted the walls brown.
Yeah.
What was happening to your body?
But I will say that, you know, what is it? That bum gun, yeah. That is a game changer.
Bum gun is really nice. You know, it's like, it's kind of ecological. Save the trees, right?
It really is. I might just install one back home in New York.
Oh, yeah. Frank's going to love that.
Sorry. Wow. Frank's going to love that. But I actually can't believe that you're heading off to the desert for 4 days. You're mad.
Yeah, but it's, you know, I'm used to this kind of stuff. I've been out in the woods and stuff all on my own. It's just a desert. There's nothing out there.
Yeah, of course. I'm not surprised that you would say that. Anyway, I love you, bro. It's so
love
good
you
to
too,
see
babe.
You.
Safe travels.
Cheers.
Tool in the heart, ooh, little Billy boy, tool.